So this is my third and final Valentine's look. It's just like rose gold inspired. I actually got this necklace, if you guys can see. It's just really tiny and dainty. It's like rose gold and it's a heart. But anyways, I got inspired by it, so I decided to do a rose gold makeup tutorial for you guys for Valentine's Day. I think it's really pretty and it's different from the pink that I did. So I just wanted to have a variety for you guys to come to my channel and basically be able to choose whatever look that you guys wanted to do. So anyways, I will have my nail tutorial up, my Valentine's Day nail tutorial, and the big voluminous hair, which I will be recording soon and put up before Valentine's Day. So anyways, if you guys want to see how to get this look, please continue to watch. Bye. Okay, first things first, we're going to want to prime the eyes, and I always use my MAC Paint Pot and Paint Relief. And you're going to make sure you do this just so that the eyeshadow sticks well to your eyelid and it lasts longer. I don't know when's the last time I haven't used a primer for my eyelid. So you're going to want to grab some type of dark brown, and here I'm using MAC in Bark, and any type of dark brown will work. And I'm going to be taking a very small angled brush, and I'm going to start to basically outline my crease. And I'm going to do that a little bit above where my crease is, so that way when I close and open my eyes, the brown does not transfer onto the rose gold that I'm going to be putting on. So you're going to just want to do that. You're going to make it kind of harsh because you're going to end up blending it out, and that's the whole point of doing a cut crease, is to make sure basically your line does stand out. Once that's done, I'm going to be grabbing a small flat brush, not an angled brush anymore, and I'm just going to start blending out that line that I just put. And now I'm going to be grabbing the light brown color, which this one is MAC Saddle. And I'm just going to be taking that with a big fluffy dome brush, and I'm just going to make sure I just blend that line out really good. Grab that same dark brown color and just start to move it down the corner of the eyelid, just a little bit to the lid, not too much, just to create that V type of look. Moving on to the lid, I'm going to be grabbing this 24-hour infallible eyeshadow from Maybelline, and this one is in Bronze Taupe number 890. And I don't know why it's called Bronze Taupe, because to me it looks way more like a rose gold. Of course, this is why this tutorial is called rose gold. But anyways, it's a really, really pretty color. This one is a pressed, I guess, eyeshadow, but anyways, it goes on great and stays amazing. Of course, I'm going to my Urban Decay Naked 2 palette, and this one is Booty Call. I just think it's such a pretty highlight, so it's my go-to highlight for underneath the brow. I'm going to put that underneath the brow and then a little bit in the corner of the eye. I'm then going to apply false lashes, and these ones are number 82 in black, and I will have the info in the description box below. So after that, I'm going to take that same rose gold color, and I'm just going to line the bottom of my lash line. And then I'm going to be taking that same angled brush in the dark brown color and just doing the outer corner of my eye. After that's done, I'm just going to be applying mascara, which is the Revlon Lash Potion. Pop just a little bit more and add a little bit more sparkle. I am using this e.l.f. eyeliner, and this one is in Copper
However, I do not recommend it just because when I put it on, it made my eyes burn. So I don't know if it's just me or if it's the eyeliner. I don't know. Try it out and let me know. But next, I'm going to be going underneath the eyes, and this is just the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Spot Corrector. Very long. Anyways, I'm just going with that underneath the eye, and I'm just going to blend it out with a pretty big size dome brush that I got from BH Cosmetics. For blush, I'm going to be using BH Cosmetics Blush Duo, and this one is in Rose. And please do not mind the blush that I just put on, because I put way too much. I grabbed too much on my blush, so I'm definitely sitting here blending it out for a minute, so don't mind. And oh my gosh, guys, the next product I'm about to tell you guys about is amazing. Something that you need to pause my video for and go out and buy right now. It is seriously the best drugstore highlighter that I have ever used. It is the new, I don't know if it's new, but it's the Flower line. And this one is the Highlighter Chubby and Glisten Up, I think. It's Pearl Chevrolet HL1. And it seriously, oh my gosh, does your cheekbones wonders. So if you guys are looking for a new highlight, definitely go try this out, because my cheekbones are on point lately with this thing. So next, I'm going to be using this really pretty, I thought it was kind of close to rose gold. I don't have any rose gold lipsticks, so this is the closest thing I found to match, which is Revlon, and this one is in Apricot Fantasy number 120. I am then just going to put some nude lipstick on it. This one is Buff Babe from Candies. This is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I love, love, love all of you guys. And I hope you have a great Valentine's Day. And yeah, I will talk to you guys later in my next video. Bye.
Oh, I hate when my battery dies when I'm filming. Then that means I have to stop.
Apartment complex, and then from there I gotta get. What? Oh, you recording? I need a copy of my Waters outfit.
Are you going in the living room?
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. Were you touching me with your hand?
I was gonna tell you to scoot over a little bit. I'm officially not.
I know. Probably officially not paying.
Exactly. That's why I told you it's my...